If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now.
It's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it.
What's up guys, I am Rob, welcome to my channel. Now guys, I often tell you that I read your comments, and what I've noticed is that you guys have sent in a lot of requests. Some want DIYs related to origami or with paper or Harry Potter. So I thought instead of picking each topic or idea individually, let's combine a few. So today we are making a mini superhero magnetic notepad. Sounds interesting? Then you should definitely make it. And when you make it, make sure to write down a little note in there somewhere reminding you to subscribe to my new channel, Rob in the Hood, where I put up a new video every Tuesday. Get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Alright, let's get started. So here you can see I have a small box board cutout. The size of this is 3 inches by 5 inches. So I want to make a mini diary, and that's why I have selected this size. In fact, I have two. So this will become front and back of the diary, but this is pretty thin. So to give your diary a little more support, we will use mount board. So all we have to do is take the piece of mount board and use this as a template. So we will keep it on this, and you can take a marking with a pencil. So here you go. So you can cut it using a cutter or scissor, but I am going to do it with the power of editing. All right, you can see that we have cut it out cleanly. So now I have two pieces of mount board and I have two pieces of box board. Now we will take some markings here for the magnets. So I have some magnets here. These are button magnets. So I'll just take one and we'll place it and take a marking. Okay, so you can see that I have taken some basic markings here. Now we need to cut this out cleanly so that the magnets can fit inside this cavity. I am going to do that with the power of editing, and we are done. So you can see I have cut these circles out cleanly. So now you can see this magnet will fit easily, but you can also see that it will fall if I place it in the cavity. So for that, we will just use one of our box board pieces and we'll just place it under it like that. And then we'll place the magnet just like that, so it fits in that cavity perfectly. And similarly, we can place another one. There you go. Now to hold it in place, we need to stick the box board piece to the mount board piece. So to stick it in place, I'm using regular white glue. There you go. Looks nice and clean. You can also put a little glue in the cavity. So as you can see, I have marked the magnets with South and North Pole, so I know in what order I have to stick. So here I'm placing the magnet with the north down, so the south is on top. There you go, fits nicely in the cavity. Now for the other one, I'll keep the north on top so that it sticks to the other magnet. If I keep the same poles, then it will repel and not stick. So let's get the other one ready. So you can see the covers are ready, the front and the back. And if I just bring them closer, watch this, it sticks. So it works really well. But now the magnets are visible. So what you can do is you can add a layer of foam sheet. So let's get the foam sheet in. So we'll place the covers of the diary on this and we will take markings. So let's cut this out cleanly, and there you go, we are done. So So now I have two pieces of foam here. So we'll take our covers. So to stick it in place, I'm using regular white glue. And with that, we are done with the covers. Look at that. Looks nice and clean. And because of the magnets, they stick to each other. But now, we just have the covers. We don't have a diary. So let's make the diary now. I'm going to take a piece of chart paper. And on this, I am going to take some markings. Again, I'm going to use this as a template because this is the size you want for the diary. So let's start from one corner. So I'm just aligning it to the corner. And I'll go around like this with a pencil, and then I'll place it so that it lines up with the first marking, and then I'll make another marking, and I'll keep repeating that for this whole strip so that I have about 10 or 12 sheets for my diary. Okay, so we have taken the markings on chart paper. Now we can cut it cleanly. So let's do that. Here we go. Once you have a nice clean strip, all you have to do is fold it up in an accordion fold style. So I'll show you. What you need to do is follow the lines, fold it this way, like this. And for the other one, we'll fold it this way. Again, go back, and just following the lines, we'll keep folding it in this accordion fold style. Okay, with that we are done. You can see we have this accordion fold like that. So now you can just place this whole thing between the covers like this, and you'll have a small diary or a mini diary. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick the pages. And with that, our diary is done. So you can see I have glued the pages to the covers, and it looks pretty cool. Now if you want, you can personalize it, customize it, draw something. I'm thinking because this is a mini diary, I should add a mini superhero to this. And I'm done. Look at that. I added a mini Deadpool for my mini diary. I'm very happy with this. What do you guys think? What? Look at that. A mini magnetic notepad with a superhero. I'm super happy with this. Thank you for suggesting. And if you found this tutorial helpful and simple, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, like it, and share it with your friends. Also, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. It's free. Also, subscribe to my new channel, Robin the Hood. That's also free. So do it right now. Yeah, no waiting. Oh, okay, I'll wait. You did it? Awesome. You're the best. Okay, so I'll see you in my next video. Until then, don't forget, do good and be good. Peace.